The year was 1968. That was the year Tiger Corporation developed a side rotary mower, the machine that has become the standard in the industry. Even back in 1968, we knew that we had to develop products that were capable, durable, and safe. Hi, I'm Don Razdell with Tiger Corporation. This video is a supplement to the Rotary and Flail Manual. It's important that you read, understand, and follow these instructions in their entirety. Now, if you have any questions, don't hesitate to ask. There are three parts to this video program: the inspection, the operation, and maintenance. The Tiger Rotary and Flail mowing systems are very similar. That's why we included both of them in this video. However, there are some differences. We'll draw your attention to these differences as this program progresses. It's your responsibility to become thoroughly educated in the inspection, operation, and maintenance of your mowing equipment and to be able to recognize the potential hazards that exist on the worksite. It's essential that you read and understand all operation and safety manuals provided by Tiger and the tractor manufacturer. Every operator must be trained on each piece of equipment required for the job and must understand the intended use of the mowing equipment. Some of the potential hazards described in the operator's manual include objects being thrown up to 300 feet, the potential for severed limbs, and electrocution from contact with power lines. This is a safety alert symbol which calls your attention to the possibility of personal injury or death. It's important that you become familiar with these warning decals on the mower. They're explained in the safety section of the manual. You must understand what they mean and make sure the safety decals are clean and visible on the mower. Now let's address your personal safety. You should have the following items: a hard hat, protective eyewear with side shields, and ear protection. Other protective gear includes a long sleeve work shirt that's tucked in. It's important that you not have loose fitting clothing. You should have a reflective safety vest, work gloves, and safety shoes. An operator must be alert and physically capable of operating the equipment. For example, some drugs can impair your ability to operate the machinery safely without having an accident, and never use alcohol when operating equipment. Before starting any job, a thorough equipment inspection must be performed. When you arrive at work, your first task is a walk-around inspection. The tractor must not be running during this inspection. The mower should be resting on the ground or safely secured in transport position. Also, you should use the daily inspection sheet to log your work. This is a good time to sweep grass clippings off of the mower and tractor and clean the windows. It's important to have good visibility when you're mowing. All lights should be clean and functional. Inspect the operating lights and the warning lights. Check the slow-moving vehicle emblem, reflectors, and safety signs to make sure they're in good condition and visible. If not, they should be replaced. Next, check the tires for wear and recommended inflation. Also, make sure the lug nuts are tight. If you are operating the tractor for the first time, here's an important safety note. Prior to shipping, the rear wheels were set to their narrowest position. They must be repositioned or extended to their widest position before operation. It's important to inspect the hydraulic system before and during operation. Do not operate this equipment with hydraulic oil present or fuel leaking. Oil and fuel are combustible and could be a fire hazard. Visually inspect the entire system. If you suspect a leak, try to identify the hose or hoses that may be leaking. Notify your supervisor or maintenance person to replace the hose. If you must pressurize the system to find a suspected leak, never under any circumstance use your hand. Use a piece of wood or cardboard. High pressure fluid can be invisible and injected into the body through the skin, causing serious injury or death. If injection should happen, a doctor familiar with this type of injury must surgically remove the injected fluid immediately. On the Tiger rotary mower, before inspecting the mower blades, raise the mower head up and install the mower head transport locks. For the rear mower, raise the mower head and place blocks or jack stands underneath the mower. Never crawl or work under a raised mower deck unless it's securely retained or blocked up. Do not depend on the hydraulics to hold the mower head.
A mower head could suddenly fall, causing serious crushing injury or death. Inspect the mower blades and blade bolts for excessive wear or damage. Look for bent blades, cracks in the steel, and elongated holes. The blades should be free swinging, and the blade bolt torque should also be set properly. On the Tiger Flail Mower, make sure the raised flail mower heads are securely retained in the transport lock position. And then you should inspect all of the knives and blade bolts to make sure they are securely attached and free from excessive wear or damage. If they need to be replaced, notify your maintenance personnel so they can do so immediately. To maintain safety and performance on both mowers, only replace worn blades and hardware with genuine Tiger replacement parts. All blades must be replaced at the same time to maintain balance, safety, and performance. Under no circumstance should you ever try to repair, weld, or straighten a blade. This is also a good time to check the mower for proper lubrication. Inadequate lubrication may result in the premature failure of the mower. Ask a maintenance person to assist you with this procedure if necessary. The Tiger rotary and flail mowers have protective front and rear thrown object shielding. This shielding must always be in place and in good working condition. Keep in mind, this mower can throw debris over 300 feet. That's the length of a football field. Always replace damaged or missing shields before operating the mower. Also, be sure the ball valve located here on the hydraulic tank is open before starting the tractor to avoid serious damage to the hydraulic system.
Before you can operate this mower safely and efficiently, you first must become familiar with the tractor. All tractors are different. Learn the controls and become familiar with your environment. And keep in mind, this tractor with a mowing system will drive and operate much differently than the same tractor without a mowing system.
When you enter the cab, make sure to use the design steps and handrails for a safe entrance. Never use control levers for support when getting in the tractor. You should understand where all the controls are and know their function. Adjust all mirrors, even the external ones. Fasten your seatbelt, and then check out your visibility. All tractors have blind spots. You should know where they are. To start the tractor, first step on the brake and clutch, then turn the key. Select the desired gear, release the parking brake, once again look around, and then slowly let up on the clutch. As you drive to the job site, you should make sure your SMV sign is on securely and visible. Also, your headlights and flashing warning lights should be on. Obey all local traffic rules and regulations. Before you begin mowing, you must inspect the area. Make sure the tractor and mower are turned off before you exit the cab. Notice where the power lines, telephone junction boxes, and other utility boxes are. Do not allow the mower deck to come within 10 feet of these items. Also, look for tree stumps, tires, debris like concrete, garbage, or fallen tree trunks. Wire, cable, and chain are especially dangerous and must be avoided at all times. Strands of wire, cable, and chain can become wrapped around the blade and blade bar. The ends of the strands can contact the mower deck and be broken off and be thrown out from under the mower in all directions, including toward the operator. The potential hazard of wire is another reason why it's important to inspect the rear deflector and side guards every morning. If you can, pick up these items and put them in a collection area. If you can't move them, make sure you know where they are as you mow so you can avoid them. Never under any circumstance should you mow with people around. Remember, debris can be thrown over 300 feet. We're now going to show you how to start and mow with the rotary mower, including the trail cats, and the flail mower. We'll start with the rotary mower. There are some preparatory tasks you should do before you begin to mow. First, you should pull out the transport pins and put them in their holders. You should reinsert these pins whenever inspecting, servicing, or transporting with the mower deck in the raised position. Never work under an unsupported mower deck. Now that you are familiar with all the controls and the site has been inspected, you are ready to begin mowing. Remember, don't be in a hurry. Take your time and become completely comfortable with the mower. If this is your first time, we suggest you begin on relatively flat ground. The on-off switch is located in a box mounted to the valve stand or attached to the cable control. The mower decks can be controlled with the Tiger valve system or the tractor's remote hydraulics. There are three levers that operate the rotary mower's hydraulics. Lever 1 raises and lowers the height of the draft beam. Pushing the lever lowers the beam. Pulling the lever raises the beam. Lever 2 is the deck roll. Pushing the lever lowers the deck. Pulling the lever raises the deck. Lever 3 operates the tilt cylinder on the rear mower. Pushing the lever tilts the deck left. Pulling the lever tilts the deck right. The rear mower's height is controlled with the tractor's three-point hitch system. To begin mowing, make sure the mower switch is in the off position. It should be down all the way. Start the tractor and wait a moment for the instruments to stabilize. Next, practice positioning the mowers. When operating a twin unit, make sure you set the rear three-point in a locked position for height and adjust the rear caster wheel for a correct hitch. When lowered to the desired height, the cable should have slack in it. Lower the mower deck slightly above the material to be cut so the mower doesn't have to start under a load. Leave enough room for the blades to clear any obstructions. Remember, the mower skid shoes should not drag on the ground during operation. The rotary mower deck should always be carried, not dragged on the skid shoes when mowing. Dragging the deck increases the power consumption. While idling the tractor, look around to ensure no one is near the tractor or mower. Pull up on the red master switch. Make sure the hydraulic cooling fan is on, then press the two switches forward on the control box to engage the mowers. Bring the tractor up to 1800 to 2200 RPMs. Press in the clutch, place the tractor in gear, and shift the tractor to forward. Take the parking brake off, then slowly let up on the clutch and begin mowing. As you mow, you should stay alert, watch where you're going, and be aware of obstacles and traffic on the road. To ensure a clean cut, maintain engine speed between 1800 to 2200 RPMs and never exceed 2400 RPMs. If the speed drops below 1,800 RPMs, shift to the next lower gear. Be sure not to ride the clutch. If your mower begins to vibrate and/or leaves a strip unmowed, stop mowing and turn off the mower and tractor. You may have wire or debris wrapped in the spindle or knives, or you may have damaged the blades. Raise the mower head up and install the mower head transport locks. Inspect the mower and remove the foreign debris or replace the damaged blades. If that's the case, you must have the knives replaced before you mow again. Remember, don't mix and match blades. When you're finished mowing, press in the clutch and brake. Shift the tractor into neutral. Reduce the engine to about 1500 RPMs. Shut off the red master switch. Reduce the engine speed to an idle. Turn off the engine. Set the parking brake and then remove the key before you exit. Always face toward the tractor when exiting and use the handrails and steps. Once your job is completed, you must install the transport pins before you get back on the road. The Trail Cat is the most common mowing system on the market today. This is the 15-foot model. The safety and operation of this unit is very similar to the 10-foot Trail Cat. This is the unit we'll work with today. The Trailcat mower cutting system is powered by the tractor's PTO. Adjustments in the position of the mower are made using the tractor's rear remotes. This is a safety alert symbol, which calls your attention to the possibility of personal injury or death. It's important that you become familiar with these warning decals on the mowers. They're explained in the safety section of the manual. You must understand what they mean and make sure the safety decals are clean and visible on the mower. If you're familiar with tractors, you know how dangerous the PTO can be. Long hair and loose-fitting clothing can catch the PTO shaft and pull you in, causing injury or death. Refer to the tractor manufacturer's manuals for proper hookup procedures. Use all safety locks, pins, safety chains, and shields required. Be sure all PTO shields and implement driveline safety devices are in place and in proper working order. Once the tractor is aligned and pinned to the trail cat, attach the safety chain. Then lift the PTO shield and couple the PTO shaft to the tractor. Reposition the shield and connect the safety chain. After that, connect the hydraulic hoses to the rear remotes of the tractor. Like the Tiger side and rear rotary, an inspection of the trail cat is essential prior to startup. Again, make sure the mower wings are locked up and retained with the transport pins before inspecting the mower blades or other components under a raised mower head. Refer to the owner's manual for complete details as well as review the AEM video also featured on this DVD. This trail cat has a patented offset hitch system. The offset hitch allows the operator to maneuver the mower hydraulically in and out of ditches, avoiding obstacles. Also, should you need to back up, this hitch allows you to do so after you've shut down the mower. Remember, never mow in reverse. The risk of flying debris from the mower greatly increases in reverse. As with all mowers, when you get to the job site, you should walk the area and make sure it's free from debris. There are two travel lock pins that must be pulled from the mower before you begin to mow. You'll have to replace these pins when you're inspecting or servicing the mower and when you're finished mowing and preparing to transport the mower. Once you're in the cab, buckled in, and comfortable with your environment and the controls, you can position the mower. Remember, the mower should not drag on the ground. The skid shoes should be several inches above the surface. To begin mowing, you should put your foot on the brake and clutch, engage the PTO, increase the engine speed up to about 1800 RPMs, place the transmission in low gear, put the tractor into drive, and then slowly let out the clutch. On the Trail Cat mowers, a slip clutch protects the drive line should foreign material become lodged in the cutter assembly. A ratcheting sound will be given off when the clutch is engaged. Stop the mower, turn off the tractor, and inspect the mower for debris. Before inspecting the mower blades, make sure the wing mower head retaining pins have been installed. Once the obstruction has been cleared, the slip clutch will reset and allow you to continue mowing. As you mow, it's imperative that you stay alert, watch where you're going, and be aware of obstacles and traffic on the road. Now let's talk about the flail mowers. As with the rotary mower, before you operate the flail, become familiar with the tractor and mower. Enter the cab using the safety steps and handles. Fasten your seatbelt. Adjust the mirrors and make sure you know the function of all of the controls. There are four levers that operate the two side flails. Lever number one is the left cutter deck. Lever number two is the left draft beam. Lever number three is the right draft beam. And lever number four is the right cutter deck. The rear mower is controlled by the tractor's three-point hitch. We'll now demonstrate the hydraulic lever function. First, pull lever two to raise the left flail deck out of the transport lock. Push lever one to lower the cutter head to the ground. Then push both lever one and two all the way forward to the float position. Now we'll do the same with the right side. Pull lever three to raise the right flail deck. Push lever four to lower the cutter head. Then push both levers all the way forward to the float position. When operating a single side flail, you would use the tractor's remote hydraulic system. Lever 1 raises the deck out of the transport lock. Lever 2 lowers the deck. Then both levers pushed forward puts the mower in the float position. You lower the rear mower using the tractor's three-point hitch control. Make sure it's in the float position. To begin mowing, put your foot on the brake, press in the clutch, and start the tractor. Increase the throttle to 18 to 2200 RPMs. Turn on the mower control. Engage the left and right decks and make sure the hydraulic cooling fan is on. Engage the rear PTO. Place the tractor in gear. Shift the tractor into forward. Release the parking brake and slowly let up on the clutch. The mower heads should ride on the ground roller during operation. To ensure a clean cut, maintain engine speed between 1800 and 2200 RPMs. Never exceed 2400 RPMs. If the speed drops below 1800 RPMs, shift to the next lower gear. Be sure not to ride the clutch. If a vibration begins, stop mowing and turn off the mower. Raise the mower head and install the mower head retaining pins. Inspect the mower for debris. You may have wire or debris wrapped in the cutter shaft or knives. Inspect the mower and remove the foreign debris before you begin again. You may also have damaged knives. If that's the case, you must have the knives replaced before you mow again. Remember, don't mix and match the blades. When replacing knives, install new knives on the cutter shaft for proper balance. Also, unlike the Tiger rotary mower, where you can vary the height as you mow, the flail's height is fixed when you're in the tractor mowing. You may, however, need to adjust the height of the flail mower's ground rollers before you begin mowing. Refer to the maintenance section of your owner's manual and consult with your maintenance personnel before you make any adjustments. When you're finished mowing, press in the clutch and the brake. Shift the tractor into neutral. Reduce the engine to about 1500 RPMs. Turn off the PTO. Shut off the red master switch. Reduce the engine speed to an idle. Turn off the engine. Set the parking brake and then remove the key before you exit. Always face toward the tractor when exiting and use the handrails and steps. Now let's go through some general operating procedures and some do's and don'ts. Before operating this mower, read and understand the mower and tractor operator's manuals. Wear your seatbelt at all times. Always keep all thrown object shields in place and in good working condition. Do not operate mowers if shields are damaged or missing. Always mow while going forward. Never mow in reverse. Never attempt to lift, pull, or push other objects with the cutter head. Never attempt to get on or off a moving tractor. The rotary mower deck should always be carried. It should never drag on the ground. With the flail mower, you should mow with the deck in the float position. The ground roller is designed to carry the cutter deck. With the side rotary, trail cat, and side flail, never expose the blades while the mower is running. Only raise the wing to clear objects in the mowing path or to match the ground slope. Do not raise the mower deck while on a slope. Drive to a level area and then raise the deck. To prevent a runaway, always keep your machine in gear when mowing. Never coast. Avoid sudden turns on slopes. The PTO shield should be in place at all times. Do not approach rotating or moving parts. Wait until they've stopped moving. Only start the tractor when you're sitting down in the operator's seat with your seat belt securely fastened. Never operate the unit in a closed building. Only mow in areas you've inspected. Also, you must have clear visibility. You should be able to see several hundred feet in all directions. Stop mowing if bystanders or co-workers approach within 300 feet of the mower. Use extreme caution when mowing around cable boxes and utility fixtures. Do not allow the mower deck to come within 10 feet of these items. If two or more mowers are in the same area, cabs must be on both tractors. Thrown objects from one mower can hit the other mower.
Never allow the mower blades to contact solid objects or foreign materials such as rocks, concrete, metal signs, or other solid objects that could be thrown from the mower.
Never crawl or work under a raised mower deck unless it's securely retained or blocked up.
These mowers are designed for one person only. Never have two people in the cab. That goes especially for children. Stay alert and pay attention to what you're doing. Do not use cell phones or personal music devices. And finally, if you see any damage to the mower or feel any unusual vibration, discontinue use immediately. Have it repaired before you continue mowing. Your Tiger rotary and flail mowers must be properly maintained, not only for your safety, but also for maximum performance. Now, most maintenance work should be performed by qualified maintenance personnel. However, as the operator who inspects the mower on a daily basis, you have the responsibility to inform maintenance personnel when issues need to be addressed.
For inspecting or servicing the mower, install the mower head transport locks or securely block up the mower with jack stands. Never crawl or work under a raised mower deck unless it's securely retained or blocked up. Do not depend on the hydraulics to hold the mower head in the raised position. A mower head could suddenly fall, causing serious crushing injury or death.
For the Tiger line of rotary and flail mowers, there are daily, weekly, monthly, and yearly maintenance schedules demonstrated in the manual. It's important that you become familiar and follow each. All mowers come with a daily maintenance schedule in the back of the manual. This page should be duplicated several times to create a maintenance log. One page should be completed daily or after 8 hours of service. Now let's go through the schedule. Tighten blades. After the first day of operation, and then on a regular basis, tighten all blade bolts, disc bolts, and spindle bolts as instructed in the maintenance manual. Use genuine Tiger replacement knives engineered for your specific model of Tiger mower. Here's how to make the adjustments to the flail mower if they're necessary. First, make sure the tractor is not running. You'll need to loosen the four ground roller bracket lock nuts on your unit. Then loosen the adjustment rod lock nut and turn the adjustment rod to set the cutting height as desired. The cutting height is indicated here on the decal near the end of the adjustment rod. Then lower the mower head to a desired level position, leaving clearance between the knives and the material to be cut. When set, tighten the ground roller bracket lock nuts. The cutter shaft for standard cut knives rotates in the same direction as the tractor tires when going forward. The cutter shaft rotates opposite to the standard rotation for smooth cut knives. Smooth cut knives should be installed so the cutting edge is facing forward at the mowing height. Grease the pivot points. Inject the recommended grease into the zerks on the pivot points. Also, grease the driveline components. The hydraulic fittings. Use a piece of paper or cardboard to check for leaks. Never use your hand. If there is a leak, tighten fittings or replace hoses immediately. After the first 50 hours of service, replace the in-tank hydraulic fluid filter. Replace it every 500 hours or yearly from then on. The gauges. Inspect maintenance indicators such as the in-tank filter pressure gauge and the hydraulic reservoir sight gauge. Slip clutches. On the Trailcat series of mowers, each cutter deck is protected by a slip clutch. If the cutter has been left unused for a period of time, damp, wet conditions can cause the clutch friction liners to bond to the clutch plates. To free up the liners, refer to the manual for proper disassembly and repair. The belts. On the Tiger flail mowers, it's important to inspect the integrity of the belt and/or the hydraulic drive coupler to make sure it fits properly. The mainframe and deck. You should retorque the bolts according to torque specifications in the manual every 8 hours unless otherwise specified. It's vital that you retorque all mainframe and deck bolts after the first 8 hours of operation. Safety decals. Make sure all safety and instructional decals are clean and replace if necessary.
Again, this video is a quick overview of the Tiger Rotary Mower and Flail Mower maintenance procedures. The complete maintenance program is diagrammed in the manuals.
Well, there you have it, a safety overview covering Tiger Rotary and Flail Mowers. Keep in mind, you must read the manual in its entirety before you begin mowing. I'm Don Razdell for Tiger Corporation. Have a safe and productive day.